For today's challenge, I will attempt to survive for 100 days in the Sandbar Biome. Difficulty, Naked Brutality. Can be done? Let's find out. We got Toni here, our lucky colonist. We'll try not to die. She also has zero intellect. Good thing you don't need that to survive nowadays. First things first, get to the island with the fertile soul. Good thing Toni is Jesus and she can walk on water. Or the water is not that shallow, but regardless. Here is where we'll make our base and start the 100 days challenge. Where did she get the fishing rod? Where was she hiding it? Never mind, let's get some food. Pufferfish. Now, that is a one-way ticket to God and he will ask you why you're so dumb to eat something so poisonous. After some deforestations, we make a quick fire to cook the food. Good thing this is a video game and you can eat pufferfish. With the bed complete, we can finally sleep. Day 1 is done. Until you do a 100-day series, you never realize how fast days in RimWorld pass. For day 2, we get our shelter built and that is it. With only one colonist, this will be more about survival than about progress. We made a bow, there are no animals around to shoot, literally empty map, but it should come in handy later. A trader, named Loser, judging by what he has on him, I agree with the name. Before day 4 ends, I will plant as much food as possible on this soil. On some seeds, there's almost zero fertile soil, so we got lucky with this much. My plants, who are not even 6 hours old, already have blight on them. Thank you game, I didn't want to have fun anyways. Some cargo holds fell down and they have cigarettes. Great, Toni really wanted some lung cancer. Blight eradication complete. RimWorld will have to try harder if he wants to be the very handsome, muscular, skilled gamer that I am, who also has a massive... Anyways, some caravan left us 94 silver because they thought we are poor. My ego has been hurt deeply, but I will take the money because we are poor. Hope Toni knows a good prayer or else this flash storm will flash her life before her eyes. Just kidding, it lasted 10 seconds. Better than me on some days. Day 8 and 9 were really calm until the sexist engine of hatred got turned on. I said it before, but this is one of the funniest things they added to the game. Like, what the hell is wrong with them? Day 10 was more fishing, a visitor from which we don't buy anything, and a Gorion pod appeared. For 10 days, I say this is okay progress. As long as Toni is alive, be Gucci. On day 14, a friendless loser wants to join us. She's just like me, so we will take her. Let's make things more interesting. We will take Maria and fight 2 warriors, but let me make some weapons first. Or else this will be a 16 days playthrough. Toni, make that club faster, the boys look really angry. The girls use the pincher maneuver to take down Burger. James cowers in fear the sight of his friend being KO'd. The girls won the day. But the entire crawfield is in flames. Alright, they put it out. Good. I told you this will be a fun adventure. A bit of adrenaline never killed anyone. I'm sure Maria will cause us no more problems from here on out. Putting the prisoner in the bed has made Haki pretty mad. As long as she doesn't kill him, we're good. We can banish her, sell her into slavery, or leave her to die. That sounds good. However, your other colonists may find this disturbing. Come on, stop being pussies. Fine, I won't sell her. Day 19 is where it's at apparently. Everyone wants to join us and our food resources are... not full, to put it nicely. Almost 1 hour later, we finally use our bow to hunt. That is investing in your future. Although, I should have invested in some aiming cause Toni only hits the air. Maria decided we have too much wood on this desert island and started destroying absolutely everything. You can sleep outside if you don't want a roof, it's okay. I mean, the house has seen better days, but it's intact, minus the bed and fire. There we go. Looks good as new. Good thing we have materials constantly falling from the sky, we can make actual progress soon. Why does everyone make me take care of their unconscious friends or pets? Is this a daycare or what? They have a spaceship, we are almost cavemen. Why are you leaving him with me? Jesus Christ. With the crops growing, we got a lot more wood. Now we can sustain the fire constantly going, because we need a lot of food for everyone. Believe it or not, this is day 25, a fourth way through and we're doing quite well. Soon we'll need to expand the shack a bit, but at this rate we should be able to survive. A lonely raider appears. I wonder how this will go for them. Yeah, he pulled up to the wrong neighborhood. I will fast forward this part, but look how long it takes to build one table and 2 chairs. Yeah, and we got only one chair built. This is why IKEA is popular. People are too stupid to put together a fucking chair. Day 26, 27 and 28 has us kill 1 dude and save 2 others. That's it. Being on an island is not the most exciting thing, I'll tell you that. As you can see, this is our little graveyard for bad boys that come to our island uninvited. Their bodies seem to be decomposing in the water. Cold snap on a tropical island. Hope my plants will survive this. Our friend Hake is leaving. It's been a pleasure, friend. Good thing she can't die while leaving, like in another playthrough. Sorry, Sugar. We forgot him outside in the cold. We are a great host, as you can see. Hope he's okay. We have zero medicine. When Hake's mother landed, she just died since we had nothing to help her with. Finally, the cold snap passed. It's day 37 almost. It lasted for so long. But it's not like we are making progress or anything anyways. We are just fishing away in peace. We now also say goodbye to Kim. People are leaving this island fast. Wonder if we will get back to one person by the end. Look at this technological marvel. 4 beds. Our progress is faster than the speed of light. Time to make our first big move. We'll send a caravan to a nearby settlement and sell some stuff. On the 38th day, Toni returns with nothing useful. Mission was a resounding failure. We'll try again later. But at least we have some alpacas now. Yeah, that will help us. Ooh, Hake is sending us a gift. A state meditation throne. Boys, we just got a Gucci throne while living on an island. Living la vida loca, as they say. Imagine being eaten by a fucking raccoon. At that point, you deserve it. Toni really wants to prove us wrong. She's running for her life. Good thing Maria came to the rescue. Another caravan arrived. This time, I will sell the 100 of fish we got stored because no one is eating 114 pufferfish. We just planted our Gorellan tree. Can't pronounce that. This will spawn some dryads for us in a week, and we can even do rituals to gain more powerful dryads to help us. This will make sure we are defended properly. Our chosen connector is Maria. She'll be the crazy one that speaks to the tree. For the first dryad, we will choose the Go-Maker, which will spawn a seed so we can plant even more trees. Don't mind the shit weather, we are getting paid to be guests pretty much, but it's pretty good money, which we will need for components and such to actually build one singular piece of technology. Look at that alpaca and tell me what you guys see wrong. Exactly, everything. Not even reloading the game fixes it. Alright, guess the alpaca does whatever he wants. And we officially hit day 50. Gosh, progress was really slow this time around. Hopefully we can pick up momentum, or I will just put up a text that says nothing happened for 50 days and end the video. On day 54, our first cocoon appears. Bet Maria is a proud mother. She has been doing great, although it has taken a toll on her mental health. It only took us 57 days to expand our shack. You guys know the story of the rabbit and the turtle? Well, there was a third contestant, the snail, who secretly won after 50 days. In life, you have to be slower than a turtle to win. That's me right now. Sugar is trying to escape while there is a raid. Bold move. Let's see if it works. If he dies, I guess he managed to escape. Escape this world and go to God. By the way, you remember Miller was bedridden for like 100 years? I just now realized she was up and helped us. What the hell, I completely forgot about that. I mean, it took over 2 hours for someone to go nuts. I want to congratulate Maria for winning everything. Now begins the cycle of madness of her. Let's do another dumb thing. Watch this. Okay, now run. Get out skilled, noob. This is why we're at the top of the food chain. We get other idiots to do our dirty work. Look at our little baby. Now you start popping out other seeds. Although with Maria being absolutely crazy, I don't know how she will take care of the tree. Alright, with the Trumbo meat sold, we can buy a metric shit ton of steel for construction. She's attacking her own baby. Alright, we need to put this woman in a cage before she kills... Oh, never mind. The dryad knocked her out. Alright, good. Toni is gonna leave for a student exchange. Come back alive, Toni. You are on the thumbnail after all. We can't have you die. Guys, watch out. We are in the big leagues now. A research table on day 61. By the time I research anything, we might hit day 200. Since Ellie is a miner, I might as well use her to get these meteorites. If she is here, I will exploit her. Morals are for losers. Our girl Toni is back alive and well. Everyone seems okay for now. We are a third way through. It's day 66. And to celebrate this landmark, bam, a wind turbine. We are leaving the caveman age and straight to the modern era. Oh baby, look at that. An electric stove and lights. Some apartments nowadays don't have that. More advanced in RimWorld than IRL. Jesus Maria, Toni kept you alive all this time and this is how you repay her? Put a box with her until she calms down. 20 days down and we finally made an animal pen. Guess the colonists really wanted to smell donkey poo while sleeping. Whatever. With Maria being completely gone, I will sadly give up on the tree. Some angry boys want slaves as tributes or else... Sorry boys, I ain't giving up. More food for us. I really feel like a Romanian now. Turks coming over asking for tribute. It's 2022 bro, we stopped doing that a long time ago. Take a quick look at my animal pen. That is full to the brim. Farmer shabby? Sounds nice actually. While Maria wanted to kill another person, our caravan has been ambushed by killer rabbits. This is bad. Come on, Miller. Hit it. Come on. Let's go! She probably has 10 diseases from those rabbits, but she made it back. She's such a beast. Those 30 days of sleep really helped her. Day 83 and we got the refinery. Knowing we started as a lone colonist, naked and afraid, getting here is quite impressive. Proud of our friends here. Come on, Moria, just sit at your fucking tree and stop trying to kill everyone. She's single-handedly trying to destroy this colony. So, apparently Toni is going to become a level 2 Siling and an Acolyte. So we made a nice throne room for the ceremony, thanks to Hake's throne. When I start this challenge, this is not how I foresaw things going, but we'll take it. And here goes the ceremony. Oh, my eyes actually hurt from watching that. Well, great. Toni, you better do some voodoo with those new powers, okay? With great sadness, I announce you that we are sending Maria over to the ranch. I know. Don't boo me. But for the last days of the challenge, I think it's better for everyone if she goes away and takes a break. Don't worry, the tree will be fine. They literally don't need her to survive. First abuse of power from Toni will be to call slaves, laborers, to work for us for free. Hell yeah. Being a bitch to the Empire is great. They give us free stuff. With the extra workers here, we can redecorate this shithole, make it look a bit nicer. We also have a double bed for Ellie and Piano Man. That sounds like a shit superhero. One your 5-year-old cousin would draw. But anyways, look at them. They are fucking near the other colonies. That is gross. There you go, another tree. Why? I don't know. I had another seat and I like the cute dryads walking around. Have you ever seen something more sad? Piano Man is leaving. Poor Ellie will be heartbroken. But even more sad, the workers are leaving. Who will work around here now? Full snap on day 94. Alright, let's get through this and we are done. Our final challenge, let's say. Mostly for the animals. And right on cue, Maria is back. Alright, girl. There are 6 days left. Can you be normal, right? After that cold snap, the rest of the days were calm. Even Maria was chill, surprisingly. In all honesty, after those initial food scares and that time all of them were injured and insane, things were pretty calm. Toni became an acolyte. Lots of people came and went from our colony. But the one I'm glad somehow managed to survive was Maria. She really gave Toni a run for her money, but Toni did it. Survived from nothing, stuck on these islands with no resources. I say this endeavor was a success. Please, like and subscribe. A lot of work went into this video. And I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.